Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Morgan, and bid you all welcome back to The Witcher. Once again, it has been a few weeks since I've done anything in terms of YouTube-related shenanigans. And as usual, the same apologies apply. It's simply just not been a great couple weeks for me. And so I've decided, whenever possible, I'm going to try and take care of recordings after I get home from work on Fridays and Saturdays, seeing as getting up early and taking care of it does not seem to work out too well. We'll give that a crack and see how well that plan works out for me. But instead of spending too long on the apologies and the plans and everything, let's take a look at what we got here. Now, I keep forgetting. I'm going to check on it real quick. I keep forgetting if this quest can even be completed in this chapter. Yeah, so this cannot be completed until chapter 3, I guess. So I wish the quest log was a little more clear on that. Because obviously when you're playing this game and you reach a point that seems like a major turning point in the story, you would think, like, your inclination would be to take care of all side quests before you reach that point. And I imagine a lot of players get frustrated when they have a quest like this that cannot be completed right now. And it seems like they're just missing out on something. They're forgetting something important. I suppose we shall wait until daytime, have a quick chat with Vincent. He might be able to give us a heads up on Azar Javed to determine, to help us find possibly a weakness and a way to fight back at him.
What brings you here?
I need a nap. I am glad in The Witcher 2 they decided to do away with the whole need to find a place to rest and pass the time. Because this gets old. Alright, so let's go find Vincent. I'm not really sure what we're going to do next. I do want to take the opportunity to take care of side quests before we move on too far. Before we even get to the tower in the swamp, we have to take care of the monoliths and fight the guardian, the stone golem. But if we can take care of everything else before then, I'll be satisfied.
What is it, Witcher?
I have news.
It's Raymond.
What's Raymond?
The Salamandra boss.
Believe me, Witcher. Raymond has excellent reasons to detest Salamandra. Besides, Javed leads them.
Salamandra killed the real Raymond. Javed has used Raymond's good name to pursue his goals while concealed behind a magical illusion.
How'd you figure that out?
Deduction, the detective's most reliable instrument.
So, Raymond. Geralt, I have to admit, good work. Full moon soon. I got paperwork to do. It'll take a while.
What does the full moon have to do with it?
Absolutely nothing. Forget about it. Patience, Witcher. We'll get the bastard in good time.
Ever heard this? If you want something done well, do it yourself.
What do you mean?
Absolutely nothing. Forget about it.
Ah, almost forgot. If it's true, and I suspect it is, then I gotta admit it. Good work. Thanks.
See ya.
I like the banter between these two. You know, a couple of smart asses with different mentalities, but kind of the same thought process. Just kind of bickering back and forth. But it wasn't exactly deduction, necessarily, that led us to the conclusion that Raymond was dead and Azar Javed was impersonating him. Seeing as we found Raymond's corpse, and that's a pretty cut and dry evidence that he is in fact dead. Alright, well that's that. We have proven everyone else's innocence. Right, we need to go back to the swamp for that. Luvarden is useless for the moment. We need the 10 wolf pelts. We need the druids to summon a storm. But before we do that, we should take care of the monoliths. And I don't think we have all the Sephiroth yet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we've only got 5 of them. And I think I've placed 1 or maybe 2. And how many runes we got here? We do have 3 runes. I keep forgetting about that. So we can actually reforge this Witcher's sword. And this guy's green. He must be important.
Greetings, sir.
Greetings. Who are you?
A shoeshine? Clean that muck off your boots for just 2 orans?
Yeah, sure.
First journey to Fazima?
You could say that. Tell me about it.
We've some heavy issues here. Now there's a quarantine because of the plague. Squirrels are fighting the Order. Monsters breed in hundreds, and we struggle with bandits. As one bard sang, Vizima's like a brothel on fire.
I'm interested in bandits, but not the ordinary kind.
Something odd there. They operate with brutal but effective force, mainly at night. Their goal remains unclear.
Tell me more about the Order and the squirrels.
The Squirtil wage a guerrilla war outside town. The Order of the Flaming Rose replaced the special forces. Hatred for non-humans grows daily. You needn't be psychic to see something evil's afoot.
I'm looking for witches' jobs.
You'll have no no trouble finding work. Ask merchants. There's also trouble at the graveyard.
You don't talk like a shoeshine.
Everyone hides skeletons in the closet. Let me tend to your boots. I've bored you long enough.
Looks like your throat's coming loose there, buddy. I think that cough is getting worse. So, it seems like there's some kind of history to that fellow. I'm curious to see if we can unravel that later. Goodness, I think I caught what he has.
Need something?
Farewell.
I think we need to talk to this guy for forging.
What do you need?
Show me your wares.
Mr. Chives.
Oh, hey, he's got better armor, and it is expensive as fuck. My goodness. I don't see us ever being able to achieve that. So how do we, who do we?
Need something?
Nice workshop.
They took it!
Thief.
No, hell.
Will you
Zalt?
Okay, so he does forge. And, Oh, that's not a permanent rune, shit. Bah! Alright. Let's go stash these then. Actually, I may have another one in storage. I haven't even thought of that. I don't remember how long it's been. Now, I think the deal with forging weapons... If you use 3 different types of runes or meteorites, according to which style of sword it is... You get the largest benefit from all 3 of them. That's not really how I meant to phrase that, but like you get sort of a jack of all trades kind of sword, and it's not great at any of those things. But if you use multiple of the same type of rune, it's kind of got a diminishing returns to it. So like for example, what does this do? Chance of critical effect knockdown is 25%. I think if you have like 3 of these on here, it's only a grand total of like 50% maybe. So like the next one only adds 15%, and then the last one adds like 5. I don't really know, but I don't know the exact numbers, but that's basically what it is. So you get a stronger benefit, the stronger single benefit from using three of the same runes as opposed to using three different types of runes. But it is not a,
damn it,
you know, exponentially bigger advantage. Alright, so we don't have more runes in storage. We will just stash these upgrade materials for now. I'm gonna stash these. I know we need one of these later, but we don't really need them now. Need wolf pelts. White roses are useless. In fact, Shani has totally spurned them. Alright. What else? Diamond dust. Anything else I want to stash? So, I don't need these, do I? I can just sell these. I don't know if I can sell these. Probably just garbage. Alright, well, we'll hang on to the books. We'll sell them when we see that merchant again. Hopefully we can get another rune to upgrade this silver sword soon. We have done the meteorite sword. So I probably explained how the upgrade for weapons works back when I did that sword. So I apologize if I just kind of tread the same ground all over again. Possibly with even less intelligence than last time. But it is what it is. Oh yeah, we have to go back to the grave digger.
That's no bargain, that's rubbish.
Tell me about it. I wonder if Siegfried has anything for us. Alright, you're working.
Rain like a seasoned killer.
Yeah, you would know.
What do you need?
Here's your key.
Learn anything?
I found Raymond's body in the crypt.
How? I spoke to him recently.
Now I'm sure. The leader of Salamandra, a mage capable of spinning illusions, is masquerading as Raymond.
Yes, indeed.
What?
Farewell.
Okay. Excuse me, that's it then. So, game of dice. Shit, who's a better... I guess we'll take care of that. Because I think if we move on to the next chapter before doing that, we might not be able to complete this quest entry all the way through. Butterbean, I think, is the strongest fist fighter that we can encounter in this chapter, so we're done with that. Right, we need Al Ghul's. Need to talk to the gardener for the Echinops. And we need to do some wolf slaying. Now, my friend Val, who knows a lot more about this game than I do, has been educating me on some interesting things. First of all, apparently, Dandelion is only named such in the English and possibly other translations of this game, but in the original Polish, his name was actually, and I cannot believe this, apparently his name was actually Buttercup, which I find absolutely hilarious. It just makes him seem even more, like, fruity, I guess. Supposedly, they did not want some kind of copyright issues with that old Powerpuff Girls cartoon. I doubt that's really the case. I think they just wanted something. They might have been warned off that Buttercup, as a male name, would make it very hard for players or readers to take it very seriously. But I just cannot fathom any woman wanting to lay with a man named Buttercup. You know, with the fact that Dandelion is supposed to be very much a ladies' man, you know, very much a player. I just cannot imagine he would succeed half as well if his name was Buttercup.
Look out.
Hey, and is this guy not the gardener?
Look,
I'm here.
If you
look like a certain. Bring the.
Ah, shit, have I used them all? I think I did. Balls. So I have to kill more Yekinops. I don't even remember how many I needed. Shit. Alright, well, one way or another, we have to go back to the swamp. Hey, Poochie. You're telling me.
Yes?
You want anything I got? Here, take the roses. They're garbage to me anyway. Such a vain woman to spurn such a wonderful gift. Oh yeah, you're the ferryman.
Transport service.
Yes, I know.
Take me times.
Let's go.
Ready?
How many?
Good, sir. Do you need a boat?
I just got here. Leave me alone. Alright, so what's first? I keep forgetting. If we're gonna do the Al Ghul, we need. I've already forgotten what we're doing here. No, fuck it. I'm going back. I'm going to find an Al Ghul Kajigger. So that we can take care of this. Take care of all these contracts while we're here. Now, this might be useful to us. Let's buy that. I don't know if we need to learn us anything about dogs and such. Alright, so. Bestiary entry on Al Ghul's graviers and such and such. Useful information on golems.
What you?
So maybe that'll be helpful. That might be helpful later. Or dealing with the actual golem part of the quest. Alright, so. Pull on all those back to him. With that taken care of, we can take a romp around the swamp at nightfall. And take care of some business. Alright, we got us a silver talent. Let us. What does this do? Damage, parry, vitality. We'll do that. Get some extra hit points. Sounds like a good plan to me. We need a mutagen to do that. So if we can get a mutagen, that would be real, real nice. We're probably going to be fighting. I need more. Critical hit. Tempest. Do I not have bronze talents? Or have I already done these? Okay, I don't have more silver talents. Alright, well, add damage to the Igni spell. Places of power, I don't really give a shit about that shit. And what else we got? Alright, that'll do. Any quick alchemy that we can do? Oh! Oh, fuck yeah! Take care of that. That's a mutagen for us. Oh, wait, that's a mutagenic potion. Guess that doesn't count. At least I assume not. Alright, well, we'll go until nightfall. Where is this here thinger? There we go. Silver talent unlocked. Now I have to be careful. Because F9 is quick load in this game. Or at least in my control scheme. And I just recently finished playing a game where F9 was actually quick save. So I might make some terrible mistakes while I'm playing. Alright, now another thing that my friend Val told me about is apparently this Drowner Repellent Talisman is not as useful as it sounds, because Drowners will still aggro on you while you have it equipped. But then as soon as they reach you, they'll run away. So that can be a huge pain in the ass. But might actually still be worth my time. Because we're not looking to fight Drowners here. We're looking to find ghouls and Echinops. And wolves. In order to complete some of these contracts. Do I have the appropriate Sephiroth for this? I do not. I don't recall if we've gone through there's that cave. The cavey cave somewhere in the swamp, and I keep forgetting whether or not we've actually gotten through it. Yeah, we need to sell these extra weapons. They are useless to me. It's back to Gramps' hut. I wonder if he has anything else to say.
You look pale. Why will I spare for you true or not? I'm pleasure.
Alright, that's that then. I'm not sure where to find the rest of the Sephiroth. All the ones we've gotten so far were just kind of ones we've stumbled across in the course of our travels, completing other tasks. Alright, so let's see how well this works. Booga booga. Alright, so I see why this would get frustrating for people. Yeah, I just kicked your stock off. Oh! Oh, you fuckers. I see now. So yeah, they stick around and they prevent you from being able to leave combat mode. That's the problem. So I can see why that would get annoying, because of course if you can't leave, if you can't get out of combat, you can't, loot stuff or anything, or interact with stuff. Alright, so am I not getting thorns from these things? I do. Oh, no, I don't have a... I only have one root stock. I must have not been paying attention. I just used them. What the hell was that? Geralt, you silly bastard. Oh, wow, you're lightning fast right now. So there's a tower. Let's just stay away from that for now. And how many of these obelisks have we done so far? I thought it was only the one, but I think I've seen more than one glowing right now. This isn't really much of a tower anymore. It's pretty dilapidated up top. I can't imagine there's too much inside either. I don't know, maybe that is the only one we've done. Oh my god, I hate how randomly restrictive this swamp is. Like, why can't I get through there? Why do you force me to go all the way around this random-ass path? Hey, there we go. Hit the fucker! What the hell are you doing? You alright there, brother? You're not fighting me, are you? We good? What am I fighting now? Oh, of course. You sons of bitches. I mean, at least they don't, you know, aggressively run away from you, but... does force you to kind of track them all down. Just to be able to deal with them. I don't know why I can't just get down there. That pisses me off. Ah, you son of a bitch. Yeah, that's right. Okay, is that the three root stocks? Good. Fuck off, mate. Now, where do we encounter ghouls out here? Because I've definitely encountered them before. Do a ritual of magic. Oh, a messenger. Oh, yeah, I forgot about the wyverns. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Damage plus 30, disarm pain, and precise hit. Oh, that's so much better than our sword. Bloodstained letter. And some valuable jewelry. Oh, balls! Ah, here we go. Here we got some ghouly ghoulies. Oh, you're still following me, you bastard. Can you fuck off? Whack! Ah, look at you. Yeah, get down. See what kind of wyvern-y stuff we get. Ooh, was that a wyvern steak? Oh, delicious. Alright, let's read this. Take actions, the situation demands, the name of our organization, with secret salutation, Luvarden. Oh, that's interesting. Well, we know he's not affiliated with Salamandra anymore. And in fact, seeks to destroy them, as do we all. So it's good. So I wonder what organization he is actually taking part with. All right, how many Al Ghul Marrows do we need for this quest? Three Al Ghul Marrows. I don't think we've gotten a single one yet. Well, that blows. What did I just do? Uh-oh. Oh, okay, all right, I forgot. Yeah, you can do the isometric camera if you want. I don't think there's anybody in the world who actually uses that camera view. Alright, well, I mean, I suppose we can... I suppose... Hello. I suppose we can go down to the crypts in, the cemetery to finish off the, Al Ghul contract. Where was that, place of power? Grab these. So yeah, we got some Scoia'tael's chilling out here. And as far as I know... Oh, there's Yaevinn. Okay, so we can actually deliver this while we're here. Mind getting out of my way? I thought he would be back with the druids. I guess he's just chilling here.
Ah, Witcher.
You've been busy. A training camp?
We must train to fight effectively.
Really think this band of warriors can accomplish something?
Can a few stones turn into an avalanche? Can an entire city burn down from just one spark? No need to answer. We both know the truth. Yes.
I got your letter.
I have Vivaldi's response.
He sends words, not gold. I suspected as much.
So my effort was in vain?
Quite the contrary, Witcher. Vivaldi either will not or cannot help us. Crucial information regardless. Did he say why he refused?
Vivaldi's gone bankrupt.
Interesting. The bank functions, yet Vivaldi is bankrupt. Thank you, Geralt. I have an idea.
Oh, you care to enlighten me on that idea? Wake up, you son of a bitch.
Yes.
What are you preparing for?
None of your concern, Witcher. But you're no fool. Think hard. Perhaps you'll figure it out.
An uprising against humans? What if I inform the authorities?
Correction. We aim to win the war we're fighting, not start an uprising. And worry about your informing on us? A non-human yourself? Humans will take you no more seriously than they do us. And even if they do listen... We are prepared. So well, in fact, that nothing can stop us. Vizima will burn soon.
I hope I'll be far away when it begins.
Knowing you, we'll doubtless meet in battle. Question is, which side will you choose?
Depends on how you approach this matter.
My own.
Naive as a child. You'll find it impossible to remain neutral in a war.
Time will tell.
Yes.
Not necessarily neutral, but, you know, I can turn my blade on both sides if I have to.
Got more work for me?
You proved apt at moving around the swamp, and performed a favor for us. There is something.
I'm listening.
I've heard that Knights of the Order of the Flaming Rose have entered the swamp. Those fanatics detest non-humans. They'll come for us sooner or later.
What's it to do with me?
I'd like you to lead the unit to the Golem Burial Ground, where have Karn await with a weapon shipment. If matters turn dire, I expect you to prevent the unit from dispersing.
I'm not sure I want to get involved. I need some time to consider.
I don't know about that. I don't really want to lead lambs to the slaughter. Until I really understand and can approve of your cause. I don't see... I don't know if places of power dissipate after you perform a single ritual, Adam. Because I don't see the one that we just used. Man, it doesn't seem like I have any of the Sephiroth that I need. Alright, well, I will be making a dash back to, oh, that's brilliant. Path to Nowhere. I'll be making a dash back to Vizima. Actually, we still need the wolf contract, so maybe we won't go back to Vizima just yet. Where the hell am I going? I am here. I want to head west to the Druid Grove. There were some wolves near there last time, if I recall correctly. I don't understand why they make this so frustrating with the paths in the swamp. Why is it so, like, on rails? Why can't I walk through this tiny bit of shrubbery here? It's just so infuriating. I mean, I think it was kind of like an inherent problem, possibly with the Aurora engine and the way it kind of generated landscape. The collision might have been really fucky, so they had to make things on rails. Because the only thing I'm aware of that the Aurora engine was ever used on was the original Neverwinter Nights. And the way the landscape was generated in that game was very grid-like. Very, it was not nearly open. There were not, like, changes in elevation like there is in this game. So it's possible that the collision, there's some folks. It's possible that there are just some collision problems that are hard to really deal with. Alright, might as well take care of that. So I wonder what the Order's doing camping out here. Oh, Siegfried! So I guess he is planning something. Let's see what he's got to say.
Oh, Geralt, by the eternal fire, it's good to see you.
What happened?
An Echinops thorn pains me under my greave. I fear I cannot walk. We were seeking the golem burial ground. Some fool, may the eternal fire illuminate the darkness of his mind, was ranting on about mosquitoes and golems when the cursed plant shot me with its thorn. Ouch!
You should get someone to dress that wound.
No time for trivial matters. Elves and hawkers are dealing at the burial ground. My duty was to eliminate the hawkers and the Skyatel, chopping off all the Hydra's heads in one fell swoop.
Guess the Hydra got a reprieve.
It was a direct order from the Grand Master. Help me. I'll appoint you commander of my unit.
I'm a witcher, not a soldier.
I believe in you, Geralt. Nothing occurs without cause. The Eternal Fire has given you both honor and responsibility.
Don't get excited, Siegfried.
We truly need your assistance.
Wait here. I'll look around.
I don't think I want to get involved, either for you or for them. Because it seems like neither of you are really going to accomplish anything if left to your own devices. So, hey, neutrality works after all.
Windblade.
Nah, I don't care about anything I have to say. I do need to talk to the druids about summoning a storm, but I don't want to do that right now. Want to save that for later. But are there wolves? There were wolves around here. There we go. Exactly what I need. Alright, you wolfy sons of bitches. Okay. That was supposed to... Oh, wow, look at that. Alright, let's switch to this. I think steel actually works better against dogs. Oh, it definitely does. So... animals... animals do not count as monsters, therefore they are not susceptible to the silver sword. Well, those wolves are peaceful. It seems like these are the only hostile wolves in the entire swamp. I haven't seen any other packs of them. So we have to keep coming back here and respawning them. We are going to complete this quest. As it stands, we've only got 6 pelts. Alright, well... there was a... whole lot of... I don't know, running around killing shit. And we do need to... wrap up all these side quests before we finish up. Just to, for completionist's sake... But, for now, I'm gonna have to call it a night because I have, shit to do. So, ladies and gentlemen, I thank you all kindly for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I hope I can, start making this a regular thing again. Because, the other day I happened to notice that my first episode of The Witcher went up many, many months ago. I'm only at episode 17 at this point, so we are falling behind, ladies and gentlemen. And same is true for Dragon Age as well. Now, at this point, my Dark Souls 3 playthrough is completely finished, and all episodes have been fully rendered, so it's really just a matter of uploading them now. I just don't want to absolutely swamp you guys with those videos and get anybody thinking that... I haven't been taking the time with any of these series. So those will be uploaded all over the course of the next few weeks. And then we'll get the co-op videos I've been doing with my co-worker up in time as well. But until then, thank you all for watching. Hope you all have a wonderful night. Don't forget to follow me on Twitch or subscribe to my stream archive channel. Hopefully we can get some streams going again soon as well. And we'll see you all next time. Have yourselves a wonderful night.